In the 1950s, there existed a subclass of people in Japan, a group not accepted in the social order, not just alien to the community, but a people beneath Japanese culture. The citizens rejected this group. They turned away from it. They shunned it. But there was one who cared.
Heart's cold, heart's cold, swallowed in the rain. Who knows?
The children of this group were despised. They had no decent housing. Their parents had no respectable employment. They had no self-esteem. They had nothing. But in their nothingness, a light was about to shine. Somebody loved them. Satoko Kitahara, daughter of nobility, product of the learned, a child of God, was about to make a difference to the lives of the children. The parents were unclean rag pickers, sometimes ignored, mostly despised. And the children, unschooled, unwashed, and dispossessed. Their overwhelming need for love and care saw Satoko abandon her wealthy home for a life of deprivation. Her unshakable belief in the rosary and her love for God enabled Satoko to sacrifice her life for the children. She taught the children the power of prayer. And before laying down her life for them, Kitahara-san led the children to God.